ready!
I'll do my best. My turn. You got this. Here we go.
Let's go, eh?
Here we go.
Get fired off, eh?
No.
Let's do this.
Let's go, eh?
Execute new data. Fire! No way. Measurements complete. My turn.
Time to get ready!
Here we go!
I'll show you what I got!
No!
It's not over yet! I'll split you! Next! That was nothing! A new power! Nothing.
Hey, guys? Doesn't it feel like a boss fight is gonna happen soon?
Man, it's freezing. I might actually catch a cold here.
We need to put those wool undies on again.
I made sure to wear mine. Thanks to Bauhaus's tailoring skills, they're even long enough to cover my tummy.
It was no trouble. I usually have to remind you to wear underwear anyway.
I'm so jealous. I wish Bauhaus was my fairy partner so I had someone taking care of me.
Excuse me? Do you know how hard I work keeping you safe?
You guys aren't nervous at all.
Indeed. You mustn't forget that we're in enemy territory right now.
That's right. This is enemy territory. And soon it will become your gravesite.
She's one of Dorfa's four heavenly czars! She was expecting us!
Jeez, you're persistent. I know you guys have a crush on me, but it's starting to feel a little obsessive.
You bastard! Lady Mariana would never be attracted to a hideous cretin like you. We took our precious time spreading rumors about a monster just to lure you all into a trap, and it totally worked!
That means Alola was duped by your false information, huh?
What an idiot. Remind me to get my money back from her.
Lady Mariana, don't waste your time talking to these pukes. Let's hurry up and kill them already.
Precisely. There's no need to ask pointless questions. The punishment for defying Dorfa is death.
Looks like I gotta do this. There's no other way! Out of my way!
Ready?
Let's go!
Let's do this!
Executing, shooting. My turn.
About this, Lady Mariana. This is no place for someone like you to fall.
Seha! Shuho! Anne!
Miss Mariana!
Help us!
What are you thinking, bringing children to a place like this?
Master Sherman ordered it. If it looked like you were going to lose, I was ordered to use them as a diversion.
Why, you?
If you were to fall, someone else would have to take over Dorfa's charity division. All of our ongoing charity work would have to be reviewed and reorganized from scratch. Orphanages cost a lot of money, you know. You understand what I'm saying, don't you?
I must seem quite the fool right now. But I am one of Dorfa's heavenly czars. I don't need such underhanded tactics to defeat rabble such as this.
No, Miss Mariana! You're hurt!
Don't worry, children. Just close your eyes.
I'm ready to fight for you!
Couldn't become a fence, and Dorfa abandoned me. But you were there to save me, Lady Mariana. It would be my honor to give my life for you.
I really don't feel good about any of this.
True, but we got our own reasons we gotta win. Right, Bang?
Yeah. I guess we just gotta do this.
Lady Mariana, let's go!
This is friggin' annoying.
Ready?
Let's go!
my turn.
Freezing meteor. My turn. New data.
Let's go in.
Keep going! Get ready!
Let's do this!
Here we go!
Get ready!
Fair Eyes!
Let's go, eh?
Executing. My turn.
My power has increased!
Lady Mariana, I'm sorry. I couldn't, but with my final breath, I could still...
Soggy.
Soggy. Died?
Yes. Soggy gave his life in order to protect me and all of you. So now it's our duty to live on for him.
Damn it! Did it really have to end like this? There must have been some way for him to live too.
Dying for someone else.
When you choose to fight in order to protect others, that choice makes you stronger.
Everyone carries some sort of burden. For him, Lady Mariana's existence must have been paramount.
Yeah, you're right.
Anyway, we should move on. There's no reason for us to linger here.
Yeah, let's head back. Hey, what are you doing here in the middle of the night? You're gonna catch a cold. What are you praying for?
Isn't there something you want to ask me? When Sherman ambushed us, he was targeting me for a reason.
Oh, that. Well, you shouldn't be worrying about that bastard anyway. Whatever his reasons, I'm sure he's totally mistaken. Or do you think he was targeting you because of your looks or something? Because that's really vain of you.
I know why Sherman was after me. I should have told you sooner.
What are you talking about?
I am a descendant of the vile god.
Well, this is awkward. I'm gonna pretend I didn't hear you make a terrible joke just now.
No, it's true. If I continue to live, the vile god may be reborn in my future children. Or... even worse, possible that the vile god could be revived in my body?
How do you know that?
As a child, I was raised in comfort, wanting for nothing. But one day, I had a dream. In it, the vile god had just been defeated by the goddess, and was struggling to be reborn. Then, the vile god began speaking to me directly. He begged me repeatedly to break the seal containing him. When I told my mother about this dream, she went pale and told me the truth. About me, and about my tribe.
Your tribe?
My tribe is descended from the vile god. For generations, they've been planning to use their power to take over the world.
That's an unfortunate family history.
Yes. My mother learned this shortly after marrying my father. She left him while I was still in her womb. When my mother finally fell ill, she apologized to me from her deathbed with tears in her eyes. She said, "I'm sorry I birthed you with such a horrific burden. I have heard rumors that other descendants of the vile god, much like my tribe, are scattered throughout the world. These people want to use the power of the vile god to take over the world and reshape it as they see fit. The same blood that flows through their veins resides in me as well."
So?
Huh?
So what do you want to do?
Me?
I don't care about the vile god, your tribe, or your blood. None of that matters to me. What matters is what you want to do.
Whenever I witness crime or tragedy, whenever I see someone bringing misfortune to others, I feel as if I'm being accused. I feel as if the evil blood flowing through my veins has been condemned. That is why I have committed myself to walking the path of justice, even more than a normal person might. In the search for world peace, I even went so far as to become a fencer. But perhaps my motives are false. Perhaps I was not acting out of concern for the world. Maybe I simply wished to divert my gaze from my own tainted blood. If the blood within me may be used to revive the vile god, perhaps it's best if I just die.
You idiot. What would dying accomplish? You met us because you're supposed to live.
But if the vile god is revived, this world will...
I won't let that happen. I'll beat the crap out of anyone who tries to do that.
Fang.
The vile god doesn't matter, the goddess doesn't matter. Life is life, and I'll protect yours no matter what.
You really are such an...
Now that that's settled, stop worrying about stupid stuff. All you gotta do is be quiet and follow me. Come on, let's go home. You're really gonna catch a cold if you stay here much longer.
Washy wash wash. Ethel, this isn't too itchy, is it?
No.
And I'm not scrubbing too hard?
It's fine.
Huh? Ethel, does Karin always wash your hair for you?
I get shampoo in my eyes, but I do it myself.
You're not a kid, you know. But holy cow, you're skinny. Like, a little too skinny, don't you think?
Indeed. Seeing her like this, she seems quite delicate.
Until she met all of you, Ethel treated eating as a simple mechanical process. She just ate the bare minimum she needed to survive.
I never thought of anything as tasty until lately. Meals were just a necessity. My only duty was to fight.
If that's true, then I'm sure moving forward you will find all sorts of different things to start liking. Food, clothes, people? I pray you'll become fond of many different things.
Why are you talking like that?
I mean, it's only natural to want your friends to be happy, right?
I don't consider you my friends.
Don't worry, she's just embarrassed. That's good. Hey, Tiara, why don't you come over here and we can wash each other's backs?
I don't particularly mind, but...
Okay, then get on over here. Here comes a splash!
Wow, your skin is so beautiful. It glows like a pearl.
And your boobs are the perfect size and shape, too.
Please stop touching me there!
Now, it's nice to have some quality time with just us girls. Wow, the nape of your neck is beautiful, too. And your hair is so shimmery and sparkly.
Wait a moment. It seems rather strange for you to excessively praise me like this. You
must have heard my conversation with Fang, and came here to console me.
You caught me.
Mind your own business. I am not so sad that I need to be consoled by the likes of you. You flat-chested busybody.
Huh? Flat-chested? Are you serious? My boobs are way bigger than yours are.
Oh my. Are we looking at the same chest? Mine are clearly 3 times the size of yours, if not bigger.
Mine are bigger.
No, mine are bigger. Aaron, can you promise me something?
Anything.
If for some reason, the vile god's blood begins to stir within me...
What?
Please kill me.
What are you talking about? If you really want to die so badly, kill yourself now! Right now! If you can't do that, then live. Live and fight. You're the only one who can fight the vile god's blood that's inside you.
You are right. I'm sorry I even asked.
It's okay. Just don't ever talk about dying again. Got it?
Yes, I understand.
All right, it's Beth time.
I don't want to see that! Don't you think Lola should know where the faith drop is by now?
Yeah, you're right. She definitely owes us for selling bad information. Let's see if she'll cut us a deal. Doing your job.
Does this faith drop even exist at all? If it does, I'm bound to hear about it eventually. But I do have some other nice information. A cash reward is being offered to anyone who slays this monster.
No, that's fine. I'll come back later. Man, we're in a bind. If Lola doesn't know where it is, I don't know how we're supposed to find it.
I'm thinking that if even a fairy that specializes in gathering intel has no idea, it might be hidden in a very special place.
Fairy? What are you talking about?
Huh?
What?
Oh, I get it. Never mind, pretend you didn't hear that. Anyway, why don't we try going to the Inverted Tower?
The Inverted Tower?
Yeah, the Subterranean Tower and the Inverted Tower were supposedly built long ago by a wise and ancient civilization. It's theorized that this civilization's wisdom came directly from the goddess, which means both structures functioned as shrines where they would worship the goddess.
Gotcha. So, if we're looking for treasure that's connected to the goddess, odds are we'll find it in a place like that. Huh? This conversation feels strangely familiar to me.
That's right! Before we traveled back to the past, I got some of my memories back at the Subterranean Tower!
Oh yeah, that's it! So this time, we have to go to the Inverted Tower! Let's move! Let's do this!
Executing shooting slash.
ready!
Interesting. Die!
A winner is us, eh?
I'll do my best.
Let's do this.
I'll show you what I got.
Stay
my
down.
Turn.
It's all over.
Oh my.
Was that it? Turn.
Data!
Thank you.
Aaron, do you remember anything?
Let's go inside for now.
You heard her, guys. Let's go.
Get ready!
My turn!
New data!
Fire! Here we go! Who's next? Victory!
Ready!
Let's go, eh?
Executing soul cr-
Here we go!
Executing Uko's hand.
next!
Get ready!
My turn! One, two, punch! Now! How good job there, everyone!
Stronger now!